Tan Sri Dato' Setia Haji Ambrin Buang, the Auditor General of Malaysia, is with me on BFM Uncensored. Tan Sri, for the year 2011, what would you say is the worst case of financial management that you've come across?
Well, that's a very tough question. What do you mean by worst case?
Well, because in your personal opinion, which one do you...
Honestly, I did not anticipate naming any worst case because I found there are several cases which I would say significant cases, you know, that we should highlight it, and we have highlighted it.
Would you care to mention a few here?
Well, as reported in the media about the double tracking, about at the state also, some of the improper investment that they have undertaken. Yeah. So, very difficult for me to say this is the most. I hope you understand what I mean. Yeah?
Well, you've been AG for about 6 years now, haven't you, since 2000?
And my seventh year.
You're in your seventh year now. Do you get frustrated when you see the amount of wastages that you've seen throughout the years?
Well, as a citizen, as well as a member of the public, we don't like to see things like pembaziran, you know, wastefulness or pemborosan, which is extravagant. And I'm particularly peeved when I find cases of unnecessary spending on the part of the government, because I feel that those money can be put to better use. We need to build more schools, more hospitals, all that. All this need money, you know. So in as much as we can save in the course of doing our work, we should strive to get the saving and move on.
Well, how do you keep from being jaded for doing this for so long?
Well, this is a very important responsibility on the part of the Auditor General, because he is also conscious of the public, you know. So our job is to help the government spend wisely. And in the process, we make recommendations how to improve things. So it's up to them really to act on our recommendations. And most of them have already acted. And I'm very particularly pleased, you know, when I see those who have been struggling before now have been doing very well in terms of their financial management.
Okay. Well, what do you think has been your biggest contribution during your tenure as Auditor General?
Well, I'm shy to talk about my contribution, but if there's one that probably makes me most happy is the acceptance of this accountability index, because it's unique to Malaysia. And as I attracted increasing attention from my counterparts in other countries, how do we do this? Because it's a very transparent, but most important thing is that it serves as a catalyst for people to really work and take action to improve themselves. And they get to reap the benefits, you know, in terms of recognition that they have done well and whatnot. So, I must commend the government for agreeing to the implementation of this AI to measure to what extent, you know, government department agencies have complied with all the rules and regulations pertaining to finance.
Okay, well, public auditors, of course, need to keep their independence. How do you manage to, you know, have relationships with senior government officials, yet still not compromise your position as AG?
Yes, apart from auditing, as Auditor General, is also invited to sit in so many high-level meetings, sometimes chaired by the Prime Minister or the Chief Secretary of Government. This is where we give our ideas. And I really appreciate the opportunity to be heard, you know. Whether they will actually implement is another matter. But I have their ears, and most of the time, they accept our views. Because our views are based on what happened in the past,
okay, well,
based on our auditing work.
Well, has anyone ever tried to influence you or your staff in the course of your work? I mean, tried to tell you what to do or what not to do?
Can you be specific? Who?
Okay. Anyone that you're auditing, from federal government to state to statutory bodies?
Well, nobody tells me why I should or should not audit a particular entity, you know. Of course, initially when we come up with our findings, some people may not be happy and whatnot, but we have our facts and figures. So it's up to them to explain themselves. They can explain to me, but when the report comes out, they have to explain to the people.
Have you ever been sued or even
threatened? Oh yes. We have been sued by parties who feel a grief in the sense that they felt that their reputation has been adversely affected. But we have nothing to worry because we have all the, as I say, we have all the facts and figures.
Well, one of the things that was highlighted last year was the NFC. Can you clear the air about what happened with the National Feedlot Corporation?
We were looking at the project, the feedlot project in Gemas. Yeah? So we were assessing to what extent the project has progressed according to plan, and we found that it's not moving as much as they should. Of course, they have their own reasons why. I don't want to get into that. But after that, the report came out, and there were other things coming out also. There you have it. We didn't. I didn't know that it would go to that extent.
So you weren't expecting it to be the national scandal that it is?
Because we were following, we were just focusing on the project. Because the project is very good in terms of reducing our reliance on imported meat. Yeah.
So did the AG's report actually call the project a mess?
No. If you look at you read our report, there's no word mess. If it's written Malay, phone desk doesn't seem to.
But you know that it was quoted as.
Well,
I have clarified that.
I have clarified that I never mentioned the word mess in my report. Okay. So I stand by what I say.
Okay. Well, my last question to you is, if you were Prime Minister of Malaysia, what would you do to stop billions of funds of public funds being wasted? What would be your actions?
Well, I never thought about being a Prime Minister
of Malaysia. But what if you were, let's say you had the power to be Prime Minister of Malaysia?
I think what the public must understand is that our public service is a very complex organization. We are having, we are talking about federal government, state government, local government. And therefore, problems arise mostly because of lack of coordination, lack of communication and things like that. So invariably, there will be shortcomings, irregularities. Important thing is that we have all the mechanism in place. So make sure that the mechanism are really working. For example, we have one committee that the department head has to chair 4 times a year.
Mm-hmm.
It's called the Committee on Finance and Audit. And recently, as a treasurer, asked for a specific audit committee. Now, it's very important for this mechanism to function. Make sure that it's a problem-solving platform rather than just to take notes.
That it works, yeah.
Yeah. So this is one of the things that any Prime Minister, I think, would insist. Because what's the point of having a committee? Surely it's not just for show. And I think what we need to do is to be anticipative, knowing that a particular program or project, as highlighted in the audit, they will face numerous problems, weaknesses, to make sure that these are not repeated again. So the so-called checks and balance, the internal control, has to function. That is the job of the CEO of a ministry, of a department. He may be very busy, but he has to give enough time for these things. Otherwise, they may come back and haunt him later.
That's right, yeah. Definitely. Mm. Tan Sri Dato Setia Haji Ambrin Buang, the Auditor General of Malaysia, is with me. Oh, thank you for being on BFM.
Thank you. I feel honored.